Hope you are fine. Before we start our lesson, I would like us to go for the COVID-19 tips. Before we start this lesson, we should remind ourselves about the previous lesson that we had before the pandemic just popped in. We were looking at something on germination. We had a marvelous practicals, and you all enjoyed the lesson. I can see you've remembered it. Yeah. But we are using another means to reach you in the house. So on this note, I want you to pay attention and then listen to the lesson. We have science, as usual. When you see me, you know that we're talking about science. Today's lesson, we have our strand, and the strand talks about the human body system. Then we have a sub-strand, which is part of the respiratory system. Now, let's do this small demonstration. So, just breathing. Yeah. Do the action there, wherever you are, as you see. You breathe in, breathe out. Do it once again. Breathe in, breathe out. Nice. You could see some movement. Is that also where we have the point? Now, on this note, we have to know the various parts of the respiratory system. Now, as you look on the screen, the other side, you can see the picture over there with the names there clearly. There you can see them. Okay, nice. As you've seen them, then we quickly move on to the names. Not the names only. We know the names, and then we know the functions as well. So be ready to know them, and then also know their functions. Are you ready? I can see you are all ready. Let's box on. The first part of the respiratory system I would like to talk of is the nose. Yeah, it's the nose. Hope you know your nose. Very good. Okay, the nose. What is its function? Now, you get to know the function right now. So you pay attention and then listen attentively. The nose has two holes called nostrils. Yeah, this is very practical. As you are there, you can see that there are two holes in your nose. We call it what? Nostrils. Air enters into our respiratory system through our nostrils. Are you okay? Now, you now know the role the nose plays when it comes to respiring, or when it comes to breathing, the role the nose plays. The air enters through the nostrils into the system. Do you get it? Very good. Let's move on to the second point. We have the mouth. Had it not been the COVID-19, I would have allowed you to touch them, but it's not advisable for you to touch them. So don't touch them. You can take a mirror and then look at them. So pick a mirror. If you have a mirror there, stand before the mirror, pick your mirror, look at your nose, and then look at your mouth as well. Are you following the lesson? Right, clap for yourselves. That is nice of you. Now let's look at the role the mouth plays when it comes to respiration. All right. Apart from the nose, we also breathe through our mouth. Do you agree? When was the last time you breathed through your mouth? If you were to be in school, you would have been in a position to explain it better for me. Especially when you have catarrh and your nose traits are blocked. You don't normally breathe through your nose because it's impossible. Yeah. So what you do is you open your mouth. But make sure when you open your mouth, you don't open it widely. You get me? Okay. Now let's box on. So the another way you can also breathe is when your nostrils are blocked through catarrh, a disease called catarrh. You are not able to breathe through your nostrils. Thereby, you breathe through your mouth. So on this note, the mouth too becomes one of the organs of the respiratory system. Do you get it? Okay, give me five. Now, let's move on to point three. Let's move on to point three. The point three talks about the nasal cavity. All of you say that to me. The nasal cavity. Say it again. The nasal cavity. Now you see, the first two, they are physical. The first two, they are physical. When you look through that mirror, I hope the mirror is in front of you. You can see your mouth and you can see your nose. But the nasal cavity, you can't see it. So the picture on the screen will display it for you to see it. That is the nasal cavity. As you are looking at it, this is what you call the nasal cavity. Let's look at the row it plays. Let's look at the row it plays. Now, behind our nose is a space called the nasal cavity. There are little hairs in the nose through to the nasal cavity. The hairs prevent death in the air from going into our lungs. Very good. So you have the nasal cavity. I hope there are hairs in your nose. There are hairs in your nose. Everybody looking at me, there are hairs in your nose. And the hairs in your nose are there for a reason. So don't play with them. They are there for a reason. What they do is they make sure death doesn't enter. The air that passes through your nose so that it doesn't cause havoc to your lungs. Are you there with me? Very good. So the nasal cavity contains the hair. The hairs that prevent death from entering the lungs. So follow it gradually. Okay. Are you okay? Nice. Let's move on to the point four, which is pharynx. This one too, you can see. Now pharynx, what do you mean by pharynx? What is it? Look at the picture there. Have you seen the pharynx? Nice. Now let's look at what pharynx means. Definition of pharynx. Are you following me? Very good. The pharynx is also referred to as the throat. The pharynx is also referred to as the throat. So now if you know throat, now you know that throat is also the same as what? Pharynx. You've added to your vocabs. You know throat, you know pharynx. You can use them interchangeably. Either you use throat or pharynx. They are all the same. Are you okay with what I'm saying? Nice. Now, air that is breathed in through the nose and the mouth passes through the pharynx. Air that passes through the pharynx goes straight into the larynx. Are you there? It seems I'm mentioning some key words that seems you don't understand them, but the pictures will help you understand. We have the larynx, we have pharynx, and the larynx. So now the air passes through your throat, and when the air passes through, the air that passes through your nose and then your mouth, they pass through the throat, and from the throat they go straight to the larynx. Let me go over again. Air passes through your nose and then your mouth. The air that passes through your nose and your mouth moves straight to the throat, which is the same as the pharynx, and from there they move straight to the larynx. Hope you understand me. Very good. That is nice of you. Now we are also going to look at the larynx. The larynx itself. We have pharynx, we have larynx. Now let's look at the picture of larynx from the screen. Can you see it? Nice. This is what you call larynx. From here, let's continue to know the function of the larynx. Are you following? Okay, nice. The function of the larynx. The larynx is also known as the voice box. All of you say voice box. Say it again, voice box. So now the larynx is also known as the voice box. It helps people to talk and sing. Hello? It helps people to what? Talk and what? Sing. Uh-huh. The Adam's apple lies in the larynx. Adam's apple. Normally, women don't have Adam's apple. I've not seen a woman having Adam's apple. But it's for men. Yeah, that pointed thing that appears on the neck of a man. That is what we call it, Adam's apple. Not all men have Adam's apple. I, for instance, you can see that I don't have some. Or, okay. But you have some others that have Adam's apple. We are saying that our explanation tells us that Adam's apple lies in the what? In the larynx. So if you can sing a nice song, you can sing a nice song, it is the larynx that helps you sing that song. Are you okay? Okay, now let's continue. So the larynx is also known as the voice box. It helps people to talk and sing. So the larynx helps you talk and then sing. As I'm talking to you right now, it is through the help of the larynx that I'm able to talk to you. And you're also able to sing as well. Okay, let's go to the point number six. Hope you are okay with the lesson. Very good. Let's box on. We have another respiratory organ called trachea. All of this, trachea. Again, trachea. I didn't say tractor. It's not tractor. I said trachea. See what I mean? Trachea. Very good. You've done well. Let's look at a picture of trachea on the screen. So from the screen, you can see trachea on the screen. Are you okay with it? That is nice of you. So we have trachea there. Now, this is the last one that we take. Now, our last lesson, we are going to continue from there. Today we are looking at only six. But before I end my lesson, let's look at the function of trachea. The air from the larynx passes through a pipe. Now the air, let me do this simple explanation. The air first passes through the mouth and the nose. From the nose, it gets to the throat, which is also known as pharynx. From the pharynx, it gets to the larynx, which is also known as what? The voice box. Are you okay? So know how I'm arranging them. From the nose or mouth to the throat, which is the same as the what? Pharynx. Now from the pharynx, it gets straight to the what? To the larynx. You get it? The larynx, which is also the same as the what? The voice box. Uh-huh. Okay. Now, we are looking at the trachea. Trachea, the air from the larynx passes through a pipe called trachea. The air from the larynx passes through a pipe called trachea before getting into the lungs. The air, which is what? Into bracket, carbon dioxide, we breathe out, also passes through the trachea through to the nostrils before getting into the atmosphere. Mm-hmm. So that's why in the beginning we demonstrated. You breathe in, then breathe out. Now when you breathe in, the air passes through the trachea. Do you get it? It passes through the trachea and then through the various organs, then gets to the nose, then comes out as carbon dioxide. Are you okay? Yeah, these are the procedures. Very good. So out of it, through the trachea, through to the nostril, before getting into the atmosphere. On this note, we are going to end our lesson here. And before we end our lesson here, I have to wrap up everything that we learned today. Our strand is about the human body system. And then the sub-strand is talking about parts of the respiratory system. Now, you saw the picture of the respiratory system on the screen. We talked about six major respiratory organs. That helps you to breathe. Now, first, the nose. We talked about the nose. We said the nose, the air passes through the nose. Yeah. Or the mouth. So the air passes through the nose and then the mouth. From there, we also talked about the nasal cavity. The nasal cavity contains some what they call it, hairs. And what is the role of the hairs? The role of the hairs is that they prevent death from entering the nostrils into the lungs to cause havoc, to give you problem. So what the hair does is that it makes sure death doesn't enter your system to destroy your lungs. Are you okay with that? I'm still wrapping everything up. Now from there, we also look at pharynx. What do we mean by the pharynx? So from the nasal cavity, the air gets straight to the what? To the pharynx. Yeah. The air gets straight to the pharynx. So the air from the mouth or the nose, they get straight to the what? To the pharynx. Uh-huh. Then the air from the pharynx also gets straight to the what? To the larynx. Are you there? It's procedure, it's systematically. So the air from the pharynx gets straight to the what? To the larynx. And the larynx also has something we call Adam's apple, which was shown to you on the screen. What does it do? The Adam's apple, it helps us to do what? To sing and then to talk. It helps us sing and then talk. As I'm talking, it will be the help of the larynx that we are all able to talk and then sing. The last one that I would like to talk of is the trachea. Mm-hmm. The trachea. So the air from the larynx passes through a pipe. Now note this, the trachea is a pipe. So the air from the larynx gets through the what? Trachea, before getting into the what? Into the lungs. On this note, I'll end the lesson here, but I have to give you assignment. The assignment I'm giving you is that draw and label the respiratory system. That is, draw and label the respiratory system. That is your assignment. All right. Have a good day. Take good care of yourself. Make sure you prevent yourself from COVID-19. We shall meet again and then proceed with our lessons. God bless you.